day pitcher. 15 points, you got to feel a lot better about it.
Yeah, Monday I knew I had a pretty off game, so I knew this game that I just needed to get involved more. And when I was open, just needed to finish high and seal my drill up.
Was there anything you took from Monday's game that you could, in terms of a learning experience, that you could bring forward with you to this game and maybe tomorrow?
I really learned, you know, there's going to be ups and downs throughout the whole season, but we just got to learn from every experience and just keep building off that.
So you said we would beat this last year. Is that related to the freshman and how important this rematch was?
Definitely was. When we were watching film, you know, they showed the end of the game, a clip of it, and we knew that that wasn't going to happen again, and we needed to come out and just play hard.
Holly says you're an excellent free throw shooter. Were you happy you did that last one? What's going on with you?
I'm struggling a little bit. I've been working on it. I really don't know what's wrong. I'm just going to keep working at it and hopefully it'll get better.
You have questions for Mercedes? All right, we'll let you back out.
Ariel, what were you thinking as you're watching in the first half? Look like you came out fairly motivated.
You know, nobody wants to sit on the bench and, you know, just getting in foul trouble. You know, it's hard to lead your team from the bench. And so, second half, I mean, we just had to bounce back. We had to play, you know, better than what we did in the first half and just get after it. And, you know, but sitting on the bench, you're able to watch and see what's open and, you know, what's not good. And kind of get the coaches feel and how they feel about things. And so, you know, everything that I was hearing them say on the bench, I'm just trying to go execute it, you know, and do what's best for the team and get us going in the second half.
What did you, it looked like right from the get-go, you were aggressive offensively. But you also like you were trying to dribble drive and get to the rim and create some problems. What was your game plan?
Just being aggressive. You know, the coaches kept talking to us about, you know, attacking them, making them defend us. You know, they were dribble driving on us, and so we had to do the same thing to them. And so, you know, I think I played my best in the open court and being able to, you know, get stops on defense, get out and run. It makes things a lot easier. That's the way that, you know, I like to play. And so just, you know, being aggressive on the offensive end.
For sure. Your own performance. It looked like you really almost flipped the switch in the second half. You really got a good one. EG kind of struggled so far this season. Could you contrast the two and the significance of what changed?
I definitely have been as aggressive as I've been in the past. And the first half, I started off not being aggressive like I have in the other games. And second half, I just wanted to come out with great energy and be aggressive on defense and offense, and that's what I did.
Is there any reason, if you're thought of as an aggressive player and you were that as a freshman, any reason you think?
I don't even know, to be honest. I don't have an answer for that, but I just not have to get back to being that aggressive player again.
Either or both of you, did Holly kind of reach into the, you know, halftime speech bag of tricks? What did she say at halftime? It was tied at the half, and you guys played much more inspired basketball than came.
I think Mandy, she told us, she said, if y'all don't come out this game with a win, I'm going to make your life a living. You can finish it. That's what she said. And I know we got another game on Sunday, but that's 2 days in between. And so, you know, we know what she's capable of doing us in practice, you know, when the doors are closed. And so we just didn't want that to happen, so we had to come out and play ball in the second half.
Sure, do you think maybe this team, the season's just starting out, you're working in new players and making the team is not as comfortable playing, you know?
I don't think we just can't get it right now. I don't know what it is, but it has to, like, on defense, we have to get better. Defense has to be better, and rebounding. I think that's our biggest problem, like it was last year, and we just have to buckle down on that. So that's basically what we need to work on.
Then you guys get out to a strong second half run to start the second half, and Simmons, she comes up with a steal and falls to the court and dishes off to you for the basket. How much of a spark was that right there? The crowd got into it, and what was that feel from a teammate that just gives her all like that on that play?
It was huge, and you know, I think that's why the coaches are on us so much, because that's what we're capable of doing every possession. And so when they don't see us doing that and getting the job done, I mean, it frustrates them, and it should frustrate us too, because I mean, we can be so good if we just do the little things.
You were talking about in the second half, you guys are up and out with full court press, kind of get you to see all fun easy right there. How much kind of momentum is that?
It was huge. I mean, our defense created our offense. I mean, it's easy when you're, you know, getting stops, getting steals, and you're able to shoot layups and wide open shots. It makes the game so much easier for you, and it's a lot more fun when you play that way.
Two more.
Your shot, obviously, doing very well right now. It opens up your drives. Is it repetition, confidence? Just what's the difference for you right now?
I'll say one thing is confidence. It's something I put a lot of work into this summer, you know, just wanting, you know, to be more of an offensive threat. So if, you know, Sierra or Megan were having a tough night shooting, then I could also, you know, help them out in that position. And a lot of teams in the past have played me for the drive. And so, you know, coaches have always been talking to me about being an offensive threat. And so, you know, just having that confidence, it'll take you a long way.
Any other questions? All right, thanks, ladies.